means that my legs, my hamstrings, side of my legs and the hip area are tight. Because every Saturday I'm driving from Bournemouth up to Oxford to see my Tai Chi master, Grandmaster Gold. And it's a 100-mile drive there, 100-mile drive back. So despite all the exercise I'm doing up there, in particular, it's the drive back which just stiffens my body up, being sat in the car for that time. And it's something I'm sure many people can resonate with. We all have to drive a lot, and then many people have to spend working time sat down as well. And many people like me feel that these areas are tightening up. So this is one of many routines I might use to loosen out here. And today I'm going to use the flexi-band to do this. It's called lots of different things, basically just a rubber band. but it's going to work to give the legs some support and help move you into some better stretches. So here we go. You can follow along if you like after a watch, and I hope that this video will act as a bit of a reference for you. So I'll put the band around the foot and lay back so the head's on the mat. I want to reach up the band, so I've got a good support here. So I'll feel the stretch on the back of the leg. And it's very much my arms that are pulling my leg into this stretch. If you feel the stretch too much around the back of the knee, you might want to bend the leg a little bit, just to soften off so you feel it more into the belly of the muscle. And once you've settled into this stretch, you can start adding the circles in. So I'm using a little bit of leg strength, a little bit of arm, to help circle the leg and work it out. It's like a little bit of a massage for the hamstrings. It's nice and steady. You aren't putting the stretch on too strong. And you can start to increase the size of the circles if you like, when the leg starts to loosen up. And maybe after about 10, 15 reps, you might want to change direction. And you start to find it may loosen fairly quickly. Already here, I'm feeling the stretch is going a bit, so I can start to make the circles a little bit bigger. So after those leg circles, I'll grab hold of the band with the opposite hand to leg and take the same arm out to the side to help anchor me down on the mat. And the leg goes across my body. So now I feel the stretch on the outside of my leg. A big mistake people make here when I'm sort of coaching people through it initially is I'll take the foot right to the floor because they're just twisting through the body. So it's a nice idea to focus on the shoulder blades, keep those evenly weighted, and then move from the leg. So the stretch feels more effective, that area which is tight. And it's nice to take big breaths into this more static stretch. So you take that deep breath in. When you breathe out, try to let go. So you naturally let go of your breath. You try to let go of the muscle as well. I'll often recommend holding the static stretches for so maybe 5 to 7 big deep breaths. And I'll take the leg in the other direction. So I'll hold the band with the same hand as the leg this time. Take the opposite arm out to the side. Keep the shoulders evenly weighted and the leg goes out. Same thing, don't take it to the floor. Make sure the shoulders stay on the mat. And you can lift the foot up towards the head to make it a little bit stronger if you like, make the stretch a bit stronger. So of course get a feeling on the inside of the leg. And the same thing, remember to take a big deep breath in. Breathe out as you relax into the stretch. For around 5 to 7 breaths. Okay, and then you can come back to the stretch of the back of the legs for the hamstring. You might want to put the stretch a little bit stronger this time. Maybe for the 5 to 7 breaths, or whatever you feel you need to. Okay, so once you've finished that leg, naturally you would repeat on the other side. So it's a nice simple routine you can do and you'll feel a little bit looser for it. So give it a go, let me know what you think. Thanks for watching.